As most of you guys might relate, APK sizes play a huge impact on your app downloads. The factor over download increases when we talk about countries like Brazil and India. Let us take a look as to how we can optimize our app to reduce the APK sizes. Let us create a blank project and make an APK for it. This way, we can track changes to the APK sizes. We will leave all the settings to default. Now, let us rename this APK so that we can compare with it later on. Now, let us add a native library. For this project, we will use Realm. But the effect will be same for any other native library. Also, I will follow official installation procedure to avoid any people telling us as to we should have followed the official steps for reduced APK sizes. So let's begin. Now let us quickly build the APK and compare it with our initial APK. Notice something very strange? Yes, the APK size has been increased by over 300%. Let's look over ways as to how we can reduce this. This is the standard way used by popular mobile app services like Google Maps. First, let us analyze the APKs. Let us find the root of our problem. As you can see, library we generate files to use for different Android-based CPU architecture. If we could somehow separate this different architecture, this APK size could be dramatically reduced. I will use something called ABIs. ABIs, or Android Binary Interface, splits the APK to different CPU architecture. It is essentially generates different APKs for different devices. That dramatically reduces the APK size. I will attach the link of ABIs used in the description below. As you can see, we have reduced the APK size to 1/3 of the when we added Realm. However, this is not perfect. In countries like India, people use apps like Zender and ShareIt to share APKs. And if you categorize APKs as this method, sharing won't work and thus your app usage will reduce. It will work perfectly on the Google Play, but not by if we simply share the APKs. So here's another method. In this method, we ditch some unpopular CPU architectures and then combine the popular CPU architectures in a single APK. So this way, we increase the APK size a little, but the sharing will still work if you share by apps like ShareIt or by normal APK sharing. You will notice the size has now not been 1/3 as it was by, separating the CPU architectures to four different devices, but it's now more or less 1/2. which is still great than 6.9 megabytes, but it's not better than a separate CPU architecture. So ABIs all depends on your choice. I mean, your app, if your app target is maybe in the United States, you don't need to do, I mean, the second one, you can just go with the first. It with this video, and I apologize for irrelevant details on my audio quality, and subscribe us for more regular updates on Android Developer. Thank you.